still love coaching. I still love coaching. It's true. I still love coaching. I am very happy. A lot of customer came to our workshop to bought some camera or whatever. Ended up a lot became my good friend. I am very happy about that. I am really very happy. Hi, I'm Mr. Chin, Huai Chin, from Great Wall Camera Kuching. Since I was very young, because my father opened this shop before I born, 1958. Okay, since my childhood, okay, I already involved in photography. Okay, because my father is a professional photographer. He shot a lot of wedding family photos. So after I complete my secondary school in the late 1980, okay, I take over my father's business. So I go through everything from black and white to color, a process of the photography, changing everything into digital. My family, I have three elder sisters, one younger brother, okay? Three of us, my elder sister and my younger brother and me, involved in photography because of my father. So what to say, since I was young, after my secondary school, I go around shooting by film camera, because that's I know digital at all, just film camera. So a group of hobby friends, we go up to shoot whatever, holiday, Sunday, that's the main thing. So this mainly my childhood and my after my phone time. Second, I graduated secondary school on 1978. Okay, so before that, my father already had the studio. They have the processing, the black and white. So since I was very young, I also go into see the workers, how to do the develop the film, whatever. So I have the knowledge already. So after my form five, I didn't go for university because after my secondary school, I love photography because I inherited from my father, my family. So as I said just now, I shoot a lot, go around, whatever to shoot. Because that time, we only have, this is my first camera, for official, my own camera. Should be 1980. My first own camera, this is a Nikon FD. Okay, that is film camera. So when you go outside to shoot, you don't have any experience because of, not like now, you can, whatever can see. A picture setting under overexposure, you don't know. Have to develop up, you can see the result. So that time to force ourselves to take a good photo. So that's a very good experience. Okay, not like now, everything is digital. Okay, since after my graduate from five, I slowly took over my father's business. I did went to Hong Kong learn from a very famous photographer. I've been there about half a year. From there, I learned a lot how to make a composition, rule of third, whatever, how to shoot the photograph angle, what to shoot. Okay, so since then, after I came back, and then I went to Taiwan again, a very famous wedding studio. Okay, because that time, in Malaysia, the wedding studio, they normally take the wedding photograph on the actual day. Taiwan date that already pre-wedding, they mean take the wedding photograph before the wedding. And then that time, we only take photograph, no wedding gown at all. In Taiwan already, photography and wedding gown is so combined. So I bring back all the concept there, open the studio with wedding gown and photography together. This is the main trend by that time. So we are considered quite early in Malaysia. La. And then go to digital, I also consider one of the maybe quite pioneer in digital, go into digital photography. Because when I took over my father's business, I managed shooting wedding, portrait photography, family photo. Okay, for when I was young, I shot a lot of what to say, landscape, portrait, macro, in fact, any hobby, any style of photography I shoot. Now my main, you know what's abstract photography? Abstract, okay. Now my style mainly go to that style already. This is what I love because I shoot a lot of whatever. Now you see street photography, landscape, macro. This I've been going through many years already. So now my mainly abstract photography. The different style, maybe the corner, whatever, comparison, black and white, whatever. Okay, you know what I mean? Special reflection, special corner. This is being my style now. Okay. Okay, currently I'm using for Fuji for years. So when the time I move into digital photography, I use the Fuji S1 Pro to took the wedding photograph. So because the Fuji is the color I prefer. And then for street photography, I'm mainly using this recall. Very compact, to put in the pocket. And then we travel for this many okay. Of course, Hasselblad Leica is very good camera. The sharpness is there. Okay, if maybe I will get another Leica maybe in the future. Is my influence from my parents, my late father. He also want me to take over the business because my younger brother went to Australia to further the study. I'm the only one to took over my father's business. And then my elder sister, she graduated from England, also photography. So went back with two together. I'm the photographer. She was in charge of the lab. With the processing, color processing, we do go together. And then also my wife, she also went to Taiwan to learn how to make up. We go together. Means that photography, wedding gown, and makeup, I got in all in one line. That's the main thing. This is seafood from Taiwan. Chinese name, the only Ye Wei Ting Chinese name. He is now, I think, about 70 years old already, I think. Should be around 70 years old. Because I went there, see how they do, and then they teach her how to took a good wedding photograph. Okay. How to pause. That's the main thing. And then that time, you know the wedding album? That time, in the 1980, they don't have any wedding album. They made few pause, one or two enlargement. So we are one of the pioneers in Malaysia to bring the album okay, to put like album, you know, the wedding album. That time in Malaysia don't have, so we are one of the pioneers to bring in. And at Hong Kong, okay, mainly is the composition. Rule of third is very important as well. So actually I saw something I want to take. I already have it in mind, what angle, low up, composition already in mind. So I just shoot. Of course, like sport photography impossible. You have the fast camera to focus or whatever. So that is different thing lah. Okay, let's say that time, let's say I took a wedding photograph. Maybe the bride, double chin, and very big, seamless. So how to pause? So don't like now, you can go for Photoshop to edit it. So the angle, the point of view, how to adjust, composition, that is very important. Let's say, bigger size wife, bride facing at the back, the groom at the front to cover it. And then the hand, how to pause, the stomach, how to, the ankle turning, to let not see the stomach too big. Lower ankle, double chin. Higher ankle, lighting as well. Okay. So let's say you go for a lighting from here, this side is darker. But when you smile, you got the winkle. So you have to have the adjust refactor. This is our challenge there. So we have took a photograph. The customer love it, they will choose small. Otherwise, they won't choose small. Only my few customer, they know my style, they know my work. But rule of third, not always like that, depends. Some, okay, not fixed there. You know, photography is not fixed. Okay, that's why I said abstract photography. So you can anything, you can turn the angle, not exactly 100% rule of third, maybe depend what you want to show. Let's say rule of third, the image is here. For example, this is the image. Let's say the lady is standing here. So her eye is looking over here. So the rule should be here. But maybe she look over here. Also can, so depend what you want to show the picture in the image. Maybe there's something here. Not always have to, the eyesight over here, they have to, here is rule of third. Maybe he look over here, also he can here as well. As I said, not fixed. Depend how you want to express in your photograph, how you want to show. Mainly we are facing is the online pricing. Okay, that's very normal. Not like camera, every product worldwide. Compare Gucci, how much, care how much, that's very normal. A lot of customers came to our shop. I will explain to them what is our difference between us and they bought online. Pricing wise, maybe online is cheaper or a lot cheaper, I don't know. But when any customer or friend, they bought camera from us, we understand what they need, we can advise. After they bought camera, we will help them. Any problem, they come back anytime. So they are very happy our service. And then a lot, they introduce their friend to come to our store to buy camera. There's many the local Kuching customer. So I will first understand the one they came to me. I want to understand they want the camera for hobby, or they want to go into professional. So I understand them first, and then I will recommend them and see their budget. So I will advise them, go step by step. at first, you know our Chinese wedding, the wedding veil, traditional, they don't wear twice. Only wear on the actual wedding. So pre-wedding, we change a lot of the hairstyle, the veil, they don't accept at the beginning. Slowly, and then the photograph we took, change a lot of wedding gown, costume, even go outdoor. So actual day wedding, they impossible to do that. So slowly, they accept. Beginning very difficult because traditional Chinese, they don't wear the wedding gown twice. This is the main thing. Mainly my late father, and then also my sifu from Hong Kong and Taiwan. I will ask their opinion and their comment how to improve. Most memory one, let's say, because I came back from Taiwan to bring the new idea in, especially the pre-wedding. But when we bring in, a lot of customers still they don't accept. So, but they love my work. Okay, I did that time because you know the Kodak film. Okay, they have every year they have Kodak wedding. How to say competition. I think I did win twice, first prize. Okay, and then so I have a lot of customer want us to take the wedding photograph. So that time because at the start, I did introduce the pre-wedding, but a lot still they don't prefer. They still don't accept. So it means that on the actual day, quite a lot the couple come together at our shop, maybe few couples waiting outside the wedding car, waiting outside to their turn to wait for the I take photograph for them. But now the younger generation, the everything go for digital, or a photograph not nice, they can edit in the Photoshop or white or Lightroom. So they might, but still have very good photographer. They still go for angle, lighting, whatever. But for most photographer, they think, oh, it's okay. After I took the photograph, not nice, like everything edit. So they, in that case, they won't improve or even better work. So a good shot. Less edit is the best. Of course, now YouTube we can learn anything, not only photography. Of course, YouTube did help a lot, but the mainly is the photographer from the YouTube. So how do they know how to get even better? YouTube only an idea, so you have to shoot yourself. Go around and they see what is the difference. That's the main thing, not like YouTube can anything. Photographer, they can go for what they prefer, what they like. And then maybe they try to shoot a lot to improve or ask questions. And then share with a group to improve. Or even can compare overseas to learn whatever. That's also very important as well. What is it inside? Okay, today my task is, macro photography, is that okay? Are you sure? Okay, huh? Okay. Macro for you need macro lenses, and then a lot of people that might shoot for some insect, very small particulars, they need a very true macro lens. Of course, equipment is very important for macro photography, but let's say it's still macro photography, it's more easy to take. Moving one like insect, you need a bit of technique. This is very important. So today I will show something very simple macro photography. In fact, macro photography can anything. Whatever close up is considered macro already.
Especially local photographers in Kuching and from Sarawak, we are really grateful because you have provided us such a great services. You have such a wide variety of products, and also you have a studio upstairs that sometimes you let us use to shoot, you know. And
yeah.
You also conducted workshop.
Yeah.
You have supported us all this while. So
yeah.
I think we are deeply grateful, and we are very, very grateful, and thank you so much.
Thank you, all my customer. A lot of my customer become our friend. This is the most important thing. Not like just selling equipment to customer. Most customer become our friend of great work. Thank you very much, all of you. Hi, I'm Mr. Chin Huai Chin from Great Wall Camera Kuching. Okay, nice to meet you all. But the camera is a bit lower. I double chin can see very obvious. Joking.